This is Nathan Vella. We're here with you, and you are here why?
Here to show Curry Crunch, mostly for PlayStation Network, and also just to enjoy the festival here in Edinburgh.
How have you enjoyed the festival so far?
It's been awesome. It's been really, really cool. As a small developer from Toronto, you don't get much chance to come across the pond to, you know, talk about games and hang out with other, you know, people that are really into games. So it's been a really cool festival. I've enjoyed it.
Yeah.
So Curry Crunch is a fast-paced, you know, super quick, super fun arcade-style puzzle game for the PlayStation Network. It's got, you know, the crazy hardcore hand-animated 60 frames per second, you know, beautiful visuals. And on top of that, it's got a whole bunch of other stuff, multiplayer, in co-op and versus modes, play online, you can play locally. It's got a whole bunch of different single-player modes. And really, like, at its core, it's a simple game. It's not a crazy complex puzzle game that's gonna break your brain or you're gonna smash the controller because of. It's a game that's really all about a simple mechanic. We call it the food chain mechanic. And it's feeding smaller critters to larger critters. And if you feed them enough, they'll pop and they'll take all the rest of the critters of the same color with them.
How is the game changed then from the, you know, it's a little bit more complex on the PS3, isn't
it?
Yeah, it's definitely.
The iPhone version was a really cool game. We were really, you know, stoked on how well it turned out. But we went and decided to, you know, take it, go back from scratch and make sure that it was, you know, every bit a console game. So, of course, I mean, the first thing you'll notice are the visuals. It's, you know, all hand animated, lovingly done by a couple artists. And then on top of that, like I mentioned before, we did multiplayer. So you can hop on PlayStation Network, you can play versus, battle it out, or you can play co-op online as well. We added in a whole ton of new critters, a whole ton of new power-ups, some special multiplayer power-ups. There's animated cutscenes, there's a world map that you get to kind of go around, there's a story behind it. I mean, I could go on for a bit, but there's a lot of new stuff in there. So if you're already a fan, you know the game already on iPhone, you're going to get a ton of extra stuff, and if you don't know the game yet, well, there's a lot there to see the season.
That's exactly what I was just about to say. Are fans of the original, are they going to feel like this is a new experience for them?
Totally. There's all the new critters, all the new power-ups, there's tons of new puzzles for the puzzle mode, there's a lot more content in there, and then if you already know Curry Crunch, you're a one-up on all the other people on multiplayer, so you can hop on versus, kick some butt, and maybe even tell someone that they suck over voice chat if you feel like it.
That's another thing that I found surprising as well. You don't really, with a lot of puzzle games, you do get the version mode, but it's not usually online. I can think off the top of my head is the Street Fighter.
Yeah, Super Puzzle Fighter.
Super Puzzle Fighter.
Yeah.
So, that's a little bit different. I mean,
it is,
why
definitely.
Was the. Well, let's do that.
The versus mode, we always kind of felt like the game had that kind of competitive edge to it, and we really wanted to make sure that it was a game that you could quickly hop into, you know, play for a little bit if you wanted to. So it's not a game that you have to play for, you know, 20, 30 minutes at a time. You can play a couple of quick matches, or you can, you know, sit down and take people on nonstop. And on top of that, there's co-op multiplayer, which, you know, for a puzzle game, is not necessarily the norm. But it's a lot of fun just to kind of sit there with a buddy on the couch and see how long you can last working together, create huge chains, crazy combos, use all the power-ups. So, I mean, multiplayer is one of those aspects of the game that we're really excited to put into it. And we think that people who already know Critter Crunch, they're going to have a blast with it. And people who are new to Critter Crunch, it's a great way to kind of, you know, get out there and hop online. And
I don't know why anyone shouldn't know Critter Crunch.
I hope they know it, but...
Especially the price is out as well, I mean.
Yeah.
I think it's in the UK, it's like 59.
Yeah.
Why would you not buy that?
Yeah.
Speaking of prices, any idea what the...
So we haven't officially announced the price yet, but I can say for sure that it's going to be well-priced, significantly under £10.
Nice.
We want to make sure that, you know, there's no reason for people not to pick it up. So if you're not too sure, there's going to be a demo, and the demo will have single player, it'll have some puzzle, it'll also have some multiplayer versus for you to play as well. So if you're on the fence, grab the demo. If not, it won't be very expensive.
So you've chosen PSN over XBLA. Any reason for that?
So when we set out to kind of put Critter Crunch on a console, we wanted to make sure that we worked with a partner that was, you know, really excited about the game. That was, you know, really into the idea of bringing Critter Crunch to HD, bringing Critter Crunch to the downloadable console space. And so when we talked to Sony, specifically Sony America, they were really excited. They were just as excited as we were. And so it was kind of as lame as it sounds to say, it was a match made in heaven. They were, they've been super cool to us, and it was, you know, it's a really great space for us. On top of that, it's a platform that home some of the best games, in my opinion, out there right now. Yeah, there's, you know, games like Everyday Shooter by local Toronto hero John Mack. There's all the Pixel Junk series. There's all that Game Company's games, Flown Flower. I mean, that's some of, in my opinion, the best games out there, even comparing them to retail games. So it's awesome to be on that platform. We're really excited about it. And I mean, we're a small independent developer. We're not, you know, we're not one of the big guys out there. And when you go to a platform like PlayStation Network and they treat you like you're one of the big guys, they, I mean, we got a lot of respect from Sony. And I mean, I gotta give them props, because it's awesome for us. We're really, you always really want to work with people who treat you well and who are very excited, who are very, you know, indie friendly. And then Sony, and especially PlayStation Network, I mean, that's pretty much as indie friendly as it gets. So
yeah. Well, finally, when's the game coming out?
So the game is next to done, so it'll be coming out anytime in the near future, hopefully very shortly. I don't know an exact date, but I would like to say definitely, as you said before, it's definitely this summer. Hopefully sooner rather than later.
Yeah, and well, I can't wait for it, and I know that.